3 Sundays from today, 3 weeks. So, again, that Sunday, for those online and those here, the sanctuary here will be closed. We'll be joining St. Matthew's at Mount Nebo during the Swedish Festival. We took about 10 up last year, and it was a very, very enlightening, very warm service. So, again, if you could make plans to join with us up there, we'll meet up at Mount Nebo. For those who need a ride, please let us know ahead of time, and we will certainly arrange for you to be able to get up. This week's passage for prayer intention in Scripture comes, Pastor Doug had turned this one in and asked that we contemplate this. And this is coming from Proverbs in the 3rd chapter. And it is written, "Trust in the Lord with all your heart, and do not rely on your own insight. In all your ways acknowledge Him, and He will make straight your paths." Are there any other announcements today? Anything? Well, welcome to all of our visitors today. It's so glad to have you here. Let us prepare for worship. Blessed be the Holy Trinity, one God, the fountain of living water, the rock who gave us birth, our light and our salvation.
Amen.
Let us come into the light, the revealing light of God. God of grace and glory,
you have brought us through the night of sin into the light of peace and resurrection. And our lives are still shadowed by sin. Make us alive in Christ, O God. Make us new and bring all things to. Rescue us, people, and move us vision. Renew us in grace, and restore us to live in your holiness. Through Jesus Christ, our risen Lord. Amen.
Rejoice in all creation around God's throne. The light of the risen Christ puts to flight all evil deeds, washes away sins, restores innocence to the fallen, casts out hate, brings peace, and humbles earthly pride. Jesus Christ loves you and frees you from your sins by his blood. To him be the glory and dominion forever and ever.
Amen.
Our opening
hymn today is Praise the Lord Who Breaks the Darkness. It's number 843.
Lord, have mercy. Christ, our Savior and Lord. Amen.
First reading for the seventh Sunday after Pentecost comes from Genesis, the 18th chapter. Then the Lord said, "How great is the outpouring at Sodom and Gomorrah, and how very great are their sins. I must go down and see whether they have done altogether according to the outpouring that has come to me, and if not, I will know." So the men turned from there and went toward Sodom. And while we were second reading is from Colossians, the second chapter. Paul writes, "As therefore you have received Christ Jesus the Lord, continue to live your lives in Him, rooted and built in Him, and established in the faith, just as you will talk accordingly." Thanksgiving. See to it that no one takes you captive through philosophy and ideology, according to the human tradition, according to the element of spirits of the universe, and not according to Christ Jesus. For in Him the fullness of being dwells bodily, and you have come to fulfill in Him who is the head of every ruler and authority. In Him also you will circumcise with a spiritual circumcision, by putting off the body of the flesh and circumcision of Christ, when you were buried with Him. In baptism you were also raised with Him, with faith in the power of God, who raised Him from the dead. And when you were dead in trespass and uncircumcision of your flesh, God had to rely together with Him. When He forgave us all our trespasses, granted the record that stood against us with its legal demands, He set us aside and held it to the cross. This under the rulers and authorities that made a public example of them, triumphing over them in His. Therefore, do not let anyone condemn you in matters of food, drink, or the observing of festivals, blue moons, or Sabbaths. These are only a shadow of what is to come, but the substance belongs to Christ. Do not let anyone disqualify you, insisting on self-abasement and worship of angels, growing in varying degrees. How far from any cause in the human way of thinking, and not holding fast to the effort of the whole body, nourished and held together by its ligaments and sinews. Grow to therefore that is from God. Let's have a break.
Thanks be to God. Father, give the Holy Spirit to those who ask Him. gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, O Christ.
Two announcements really quick. Larry, Sharon, it's so great to see you back. I looked out and I went, oh my goodness, they're here. Well, it's good to have you back. It's good to see you, and you're looking great, Larry. Thank you for coming to visit with us. The second announcement is kind of an affirmation of my message today. And I have read through the first reading today, but it kind of goes to this, the persistence of Abraham in asking over and over. Understand now. Come on, you know you want to. No other set of words could compel us to action as children than the word come on. And I dare you in all its conjugations, I double dare, triple dare, and all the degrees of dog dares to it. And you strengthen the come on to cause the person it is issued to act quickly. Or to give a deeper thought to whatever the command was for. Now, this was usually preserved for auspicious occasions of death-defying, parent-forbidding activities. The command was a neighborhood statement, and its cry would call everyone near to see what acts of courage, agility, rule-breaking, or stupidity. From the kid's point of view, from the parent's point of view, would require so strong an oath and legal verbiage. Your reputation rested on these occasions of challenge in the neighborhood, and the consequences in your response would last a lifetime. Well, at least at the time you thought of it. Okay, so if you broke something, that lasted a lifetime, but otherwise, no. In today's reading from Luke, we are introduced to the Our Father, the Lord's Prayer. What and how we are to pray. Now, this prayer is found in both Matthew and Luke's Gospels, varying in each translation. Now, Matthew's Gospel was written for a Judeo-Christian audience, and Luke's for a Greek Gentile audience. And these account for the differences we see between them. Now, in the early church, the apostles, in their Acts, required that the church prayed this prayer three times a day, morning, noon, and night, and included the benediction, or as we know, for thine is the kingdom, and so on, to be added each time that it was said. Matthew's audience would have seen a great similarity to the Abba prayer. This prayer, by Jews, said three times a day, is remarkably like the Our Father. This prayer has 19 different supplications within it, and like the two great commandments given by Jesus, were simplified for us to cover all 19 areas in one simple prayer. This prayer, the first century Jews and Jesus would have been familiar with and prayed with several times daily. But looking at Luke's audience, being Gentiles, they wouldn't have known it this relevant. But the prayer that Jesus gives is easier to learn and easier to learn. But in this simple prayer, Jesus is teaching us a valuable lesson, a lesson the Amidah or other types of prayer and supplication for this time in Judaism that it contradicted their form. The Amidah, when addressing God, the Creator, addressed him as a very formal, very inaccessible God. Even the name of God is not even to be said for fear of condemnation or fear of risking violation of the second commandment. Thou shalt not use the Lord's name in vain or offer oaths. In respect of fear of and servitude to God so far away, so far removed, at least they thought in this people. As an example, the first supplication of the prayer Amidah reads, Blessed are you, O Lord, our and God of our fathers, the God of Abraham, the God of Isaac, and the God of Jacob, the great God, the Most High God, who bestows loving kindness, the Creator of all things, who remembers the good deeds of the patriarchs, and in love will bring a Redeemer to their children's children in His namesake. O King, Helper, Savior, and Shield, blessed are You, O Lord, the Shield of Abraham. In all of that, Jesus tells us, our Father. Jesus is showing us that God is not only His Father, but ours as well. And that God is acting like a father caring for a child, that He is with us. Now last week we talked about God being portable. He is everywhere. And His greatness doesn't require a temple for Him to be great. We can speak to God anywhere, here at church or at home. Today Jesus reveals that our God is personal, that He is our Father, who acts like our earthly fathers would. In the parable of the child Jesus uses, He's asking a child asking a father for a fish or an egg. Jesus shows our God does not stay far away ignoring us or punish the asker by giving them harm or despair or death. God loves His people. He loves us. And He wants us to be with Him. He wants us to be faithful. He wants to be not our Father, but wants to be our Abba, our Daddy. He wants us to run and crawl up to Him like little children, crawl up into His lap, but in His presence, and not to fear Him so much that love becomes impossible. He wants us to share our joy and pain, our wants and needs, abundance and even scarcity. To the gift of Jesus, we now have a direct line, a hotline number to God that we can use when we need as we carry Him where we go. Thanks to the grace given in faith through the sacraments. But with all that, my aha moment this week in the middle of the gospel reading came from there. So I say to you, ask and it will be given to you. Search and you will find, knock and the door will be opened for you. For everyone who asks receives, and everyone who searches finds, and for everyone who knocks, the door will be opened. Truth there, but one which is forgotten. Did you ask? Did you go to the great I Am Who I Am and say, please, Heavenly Father, can you? Were we consistent and persistent? Did you thank Him for the egg or fish that He's already given? Or did you change to read the end of that prayer, the benediction to read from, or change it from, for thine is, to mine is, the kingdom, the power, the glory. Did we ask for help, and when it came, took credit, and even ignored God's provision for our gift given, His love for His people? Think about this last from the past in our playgrounds of our youth. My dad is stronger than your dad. I don't know how many times I have heard that. What happened after? What was our response? Usually it would start an argument and then sometimes a fight between children. My dad's bigger than your dad. Oh yeah, well my dad's richer than your dad. No, no. It seems foolish now, right? But the fervent love we have for our earthly dads defied logic and reason. Because these people were our first heroes. They were our first shelter, our first providers that we knew. But yet we allow power, extreme wealth, comfort, treasure, lust, greed, and many other worldly examples to be more than our God. Our Heavenly Daddy is charging us, is challenging us, that we're hearing on the playground earth. But who or what is bigger or stronger, wiser, many times not our Father, but has heard in His defense. We don't hear that. Who will triple God dare in the world that God is great? His name above all. You will. Or at least we should. into series, where we break down the Our Father into tiny little pieces and compare it to the Abba and other prayers of the time. I'll tell you, that's for another time. There are 19 passages. I must close this now, because the gift of the word given today precedes the gift of sustenance of the Eucharist. Besides active service today, we need to meet those who put in playground earth, who we've been given to serve, comfort, teach, and heal. Goodness knows the playground now is much more dangerous than when we were young. And we must be there as He, as Jesus is there. I'll leave you with this thought. It is quite easy to memorize the Lord's Prayer. Most of us were taught this prayer at catechism in our youth and before confirmation. Today, in our service, as we say this prayer, slow down just a little and say it like the first time that you said it. See the words you are saying and let them enter your heart. Maybe like this. Our Father, Abba, Daddy, who is everywhere, the eternal, infinite King of heaven, it is in awe and reverence that your name crosses my lips, because it's you, my Father, who prays. You have promised your great kingdom to be our eternal home after this life, and we promise to try to act and work in your will, which is the rule and measure of our lives here on earth and in heaven. We thank you for the manna, the bread from heaven, in your good grace you provide endlessly. And let us walk with you again blameless, forgiven, with those we forgive here as we walk together hand in hand to you. Keep the paths we walk safe from death and sin. Look toward you only as we walk with the Spirit guiding us in this sinful world. Because you are my Abba, my Father, my Daddy, and give us everything we need. We can only thank you for sharing your home, and by your power, all light and blessings flow. Not just today or yesterday, but for all the yesterdays and the tomorrows yet to come, until we stand before you and call to us as your child, to sit at your feet always, as your servant and friend. I truly believe this and agree with this with all my fellow siblings in Christ. So I say to you, come on. Come on, ask him. Ask him all of you. Ask him a lot. I triple God Mary. Amen.
Amen.
As we stand together as one church, part of the body of Christ, let us recite together the Apostles' Creed.
I believe in God, Father Almighty, creator of heaven and earth. I believe in Jesus Christ, God's only Son, our Lord, who was conceived by the Holy Spirit, born of the Virgin Mary, suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died, and was buried. He descended to the dead. On the third day he rose again. He ascended to heaven. He is seated at the right hand of the Father, and he will come to judge the living and dead. I am the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and the life everlasting. Amen. Trusting to God's extraordinary love, let us come near to the Holy One in prayer. Rooted and built up in Christ, we pray for the church. Embolden church leaders to take risks for the sake of the gospel and equip the baptized to proclaim your extravagant love for the whole world. Merciful God,
receive our prayer.
Rejoicing in the works of your hands, we pray for the natural world. May rivers, lakes, oceans, and all waterways sparkle with your radiance. Protect water sources, the Bradford watershed, and strengthen those who defend them. Merciful God,
receive our prayer.
Interceding on behalf of the vulnerable, we pray for the peoples of the world. Inspire our rulers and governing authorities with your justice. Guide the work of legislators and public officials that they advocate for the well-being of those they serve. Merciful God,
receive our prayer.
Persistent in prayer, we pray for our neighbors in need. To all who have hunger, give daily bread. To all who have bread, give hunger for justice. Open us to the cries of those who suffer, especially Anthony Sprague, Jim Henry, Alex Capella, Norm Runyon Jr., Mary Delaney, Patricia Wall, Doris Baca, Debbie Shirk, Larry Shine, Holly Bernardi, Todd Erickson, Cindy Soley, Gregory Buckner, Lois Schultz, Joyce Maxwell, Marlene Kiowski, Steve Cavallaro, Robbie Swin, Lou Montai, Bishop Lozano, Lori Marcella, Betty Fraley, Alex and Mary Lou Nemeth, Ricky Hillhouse, John Stack, Ann Brody, Pat Rizzuti, Jan Ernest, Mary Jo Callahan, Dan Lewis Jr., Andy and Pam Lloyd, family and friends of Bill Matthews, and anyone we name.
Pam Walter, Fred, Dave and Sherry Sterner, Greg Fisher, John Wickett.
Merciful God,
receive our prayer.
Abounding in thanksgiving, we pray for this congregation. Bless the prayer and fellowship ministries in this place. Call us together times of praise and blessing, trouble and sorrow, in your holy name. Merciful God,
receive our prayer.
Buried with Christ in baptism and raised with him to new life, we give thanks to your saints who rest in your eternal presence. Join our voices with theirs as we sing of your great glory. Merciful God,
receive our prayer.
Heavenly Father, receive the prayers of your children, merciful God, and hold us forever in your steadfast love. Through Jesus Christ, our holy wisdom.
Amen, amen.
The peace of the Lord be with all of you.
And also with you.
Let us offer each other a sign of peace.
Peace be with you. Peace be with you. Merciful God, open wide your hand. Satisfy the need of every living thing. Jesus Christ. When our congregation gathered for the celebration of Holy Communion, we heard again the story of God's mighty acts and the love shown us in the death and the resurrection of our Lord Jesus Christ. With thanksgiving, remember that in the night in which he was betrayed, he took the bread, gave thanks, broke it, gave to the disciples, saying, "Take and eat, this is my body given for you. Do this for the remembrance of me." Again, after supper, he took the cup, gave thanks, gave it for all to drink, saying, "This cup is a new covenant in my blood, shed for you and for all people for the forgiveness of sin. Do this for remembrance of me." We're given assurance of our Lord's presence through this gift of the Holy Spirit. Now we bring to you the same bread of life and the same cup of blessing, that you may be strengthened through your participation in the body of Christ. Lord, remember us your kingdom and teach us to pray. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom and the power and the glory forever and ever. Amen.
Thank you.
body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ, strengthen and preserve you in eternal life.
Amen.
Our sending hymn today, my life.